हेलो गाइस, गुड मॉर्निंग। आई एम संतोष सिंह एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू इंपोर्ट डेटा फ्रॉम MySQL टू हाइव यूजिंग स्कोप। सो लेट्स सी दैट हाउ वी कैन इंपोर्ट डेटा इनटू हाइव एंड वेलकम टू माय चैनल। सो एज वी हैव सीन दैट हाउ टू इंपोर्ट डेटा फ्रॉम RDBMS टू HDFS। सो we have seen so many times that how we can import data from RDBMS to HDFS. For doing this, we need to write a scope statement like this way. And we have write this statement so many times. And when we execute this statement, then scope import student table data to this target locations. So like this way, we can import data from MySQL to Hive. And when scope import data schema to Hive table, it write from MySQL to temporary HDFS locations, and after that from temporary HDFS locations to Hive table. So how MySQL table schema convert to Hive? It convert MySQL data types to Java data types, means scope convert MySQL data types to Java data types and from Java data types to Hive data types. So scope do these things. It means when we import data from MySQL to Hive, then it do in first it convert MySQL data types to Java data types and from Java data types to Hive data types. It means suppose on MySQL there is worker, so it convert worker to string, and after that it convert string to string. So as we know that scope code is written in Java, scope internally convert MySQL database to Java data types and Java data types to Hive data types. Scope do these things internally. We do not bother about these things. So now let's see the next things. What require for import data into Hive? So for import record into Hive, following options are required in scope statement. These two options are required in scope statement for importing data from RDBMS to Hive. First requirement is double hyphen hive hyphen import keyword, and second requirement is double hyphen hive hyphen table space table name. So these two things require when we importing data from RDBMS to Hive. So double hyphen hive hyphen import keyword tell scope to import into Hive, and double hyphen hive hyphen table points to table. It means as we write here table name where data is to be put into Hive, means double hyphen hive hyphen table points to table where data is to be put into Hive. When we specify double hyphen hive hyphen table space table name, so it specify that on which table we are going to store data from RDBMS to Hive. So like this way we can see example. In this example we can see that we need to write a scope statement the same way, scope space double hyphen import space, this is the connection string, after that we put the table name, means this is the RDBMS table from where we want to import data, and after that we put double hyphen hive hyphen import space double hyphen hive hyphen table space table name, and this is the Hive table name. In this table name we want to store data, so we can specify the table name like this, and after that we specify hyphen m space 1 means how many number of mapper should run. So we can specify like this way. And when scoop execute this statement, then it import student table record to this student table. It means from RDBMS student tables to hype student table. So like this way, scoop import into hype. It's very simple to storing data from RDBMS to hype. We only need to put this keyword and scoop import from RDBMS to hype. So this way how we have data in MySQL, the same type and data stored in hype by scoop. The same data types how we have in MySQL, the same data types stored in hype when we import. And the second point is, as we write SQL query in MySQL, the same kinds of query we have in hype. As we write in SQL, select star from table name, the same way we write in hype, select star from table name. So we will see in detail that how we can write SQL in hype. That's all in today's topic. Thanks for watching and please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.